ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming. We hope that we're going to entertain you tonight. We are celebrating, are we not, 50 years of Well Boring, is that right? So we have chosen songs going back to 1967. Baby Now That I Found You was written by English songwriters Macaulay and MacLeod and was number one in the UK for the Foundations in 1967. Their debut single on the newly launched BBC Radio 1. I can't see anybody. Part of the song was written in the same bar of a Soho tavern where Karl Marx is supposed to have written Das Kapital. Alison Krauss had chart-topping success with her beautiful country version in 1995. And I have to say, I prefer it to the version on the Going Coconuts album by the Big White Smile duo Donny and Marie Osmond. The lyrics are a plea for an unnamed subject to not break up with a singer. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you go coconuts for our version. Shall I be Marie and you Donny? This next song was written in '66 by Carson Parks. Whilst he and his wife recorded it first, it's best known by Frank Sinatra and his daughter Nancy for the US chart-topping, gold-selling 1967 version. It was the first and only instance of a father-daughter number one song in America. Frank had played Park's recording to his daughter's producer, Lee Hazelwood, who recalled, "He asked me, 'Do you like it?' And I said, 'I love it. And if you don't sing it with Nancy, I will.' He said, 'We're going to do it. Book a studio.'" Of course, you may also be familiar with the UK number one that was in 2001, the cover version by Robbie Williams and Nicole Kidman. Frank or Robbie?
Robbie, I think Robbie, yeah.
Sure.
I don't think that was revolutionary music even at the time.
I meant to say you could have sung along then.
Yeah, please sing along to us. You'll probably know this one as well.
This next song, Will You Love Me Tomorrow, also known as Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, is a song written by Jerry Coffin and Carole King. Originally recorded in 1960 by the Shirelles, it was the first song by an all-girl group to reach number one in America. Recorded since by many artists over the years, Dusty Springfield in 64, Cher in 66, The Four Seasons in 68, the fabulous Carole King had success with it in 1971, and the list continues. So this is our three-boy, one-girl 2017 version, which may or may not enter the UK charts, but we hope you like it anyway.
Thank you.
Say a Little Prayer is a song written by Burt Bacharach and Hal David for Dionne Warwick. Bacharach's recordings with Warwick often only took no more than 3 takes, sometimes even 1. But on this occasion, even after 10 takes and completion, he felt unhappy with its rushed sound. But Scepter Records released it as a B-side to the much slower theme from The Valley of the Dolls, upon which it was favoured and peaked at number 4, giving Dionne Warwick's career a boost. The song's intention was to convey a woman's concern for her man who was serving in the Vietnam War. Celebrates the famous New York jazz club Birdland, named after the saxophonist Charlie Bird Parker, which was a venue for many leading jazz musicians. Written in only 10 minutes, it was his biggest commercial hit. Shearing often joked about the success of Lullaby of Birdland. At his 80th birthday celebration at Carnegie Hall in 1999, he introduced the song by saying, "I've been credited with writing 300 songs. 299 enjoyed a bumpy ride from relative obscurity to total oblivion. Here is the other one." Though also on a previous album, our link to 1967 is that Lullaby of Birdland appeared on Ella and Duke at the Côte d'Azur, a 1967 live album by Ella Fitzgerald, accompanied by the big band of Duke Ellington.
Thanks a lot. Lovely.